Hello viewer, how are you? Welcome to Samuel Academy. Today I want to bring you a Bible story about Moses, the man of God. Let's begin. Moses was born during the time when Pharaoh, king of Egypt, had charged all his people to cast every son that was born into the Nile River. The father of Moses was called Amram, and his mother was called Jochebed. Moses was a good-looking child. When he was born, his mother hid him for 3 months, and after that, she could not hide him anymore. So she made an ark for him and put him in it and laid it by the brink of the Nile River. Pharaoh's daughter discovered the ark with the child inside, and he had compassion on Moses. Miriam, the sister to Moses, was near. She volunteered to seek for a nurse that would care for the child on behalf of Pharaoh's daughter. She went and called her mother to nurse the child. Pharaoh's daughter allowed Miriam's mother to nurse the child for her, without knowing that it was the mother to Moses, and she offered to give her wages. Pharaoh's daughter named the child Moses because she said she drew him out of the water. Moses grew up in Pharaoh's palace. One day, when he had grown up, he saw an Egyptian smiting an Hebrew, one of his brethren. He slew the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. When he realized that what he did was known, he fled from the face of Pharaoh and dwelt in the land of Midian. This is where the land of Midian is. It's the Red Sea. It's Midian. So he flew from Egypt, this part of Egypt, to Midian. Right, let's continue. In Midian, he delivered the 7 daughters of Reuel from the hand of the shepherds at the well. Therefore, Reuel welcomed him in his home to live with him and gave him his daughter Zipporah as wife. Moses also kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law. Reuel was also called Jethro. Moses had a son called Gershom. The angel of the Lord appeared to Moses in a flame of fire out of the midst of the bush. Moses saw the bush burn, but it was not consumed. God called Moses at the burning bush and revealed himself to him as I am. So the burning bush was around this mountain, Mount Sinai or Horeb. God called Moses in order to go and deliver the children of Israel from the land of Egypt. Moses was not eloquent. He was slow of speech and of a slow tongue. He had a brother called Aaron. After Moses was called by God, he requested his father-in-law to let him go back to Egypt. His father-in-law granted him leave, so he went to Egypt with his wife, sons, and the rod of God in his hand. When Moses went to Pharaoh, he went with his brother Aaron. Pharaoh did not listen to Moses and Aaron. Instead, he made the work of the children of Israel more difficult. The people complained against Moses. So Moses went back to the Lord, who revealed his name to Moses as Jehovah. Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh many times to ask him to let the people go. Pharaoh was not willing to let the people go. The land of Egypt was struck with the different plagues, and every time it happened, Pharaoh asked Moses to pray to God to take away the plagues. Whenever the plague was taken away, Pharaoh hardened his heart and refused to let the people go. The last plague that did a big blow to Pharaoh and his people was the death of the firstborn among both the children and the animals. This made Pharaoh allow Israel to go. When Israel left Egypt, Moses remembered to take the bones of Joseph with him. Moses lifted up his rod and stretched out his hand over the sea, and the water parted so that the children of Israel went through the Red Sea on dry ground. This miracle happened because the Egyptians were pursuing the children of Israel to take them back to Egypt. Following this great deliverance, Moses and the people sang a song to honor the Lord who had delivered them from the Egyptians. The waters of Marah were bitter. The people could not drink it, so the Lord showed Moses a plant which he took and cast into the waters, and the waters became sweet. During the battle with Amalek, Moses lifted his hands, and Aaron and Hur supported him. That is when the hands grew heavy. Israel prevailed against Amalek when the hands of Moses were lifted up. Moses listened to the advice of Jethro, his father-in-law, and delegated some of the responsibilities to other leaders so that he could handle more difficult issues only. God met Moses on top of Mount Sinai or Mount Horeb and gave him the Ten Commandments on tablets of stone. He also gave Moses a pattern of the sanctuary. Moses stayed in the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. The people saw that Moses had delayed, so they made a molten calf and worshipped it and sacrificed to it. When Moses saw the molten calf and the people dancing, he cast down the tablets of stone on which the Lord had written the Ten Commandments, and he broke them. The Lord spoke to Moses face to face, as a man speaks unto his friend. Moses asked to see the glory of God. The Lord put him in a cleft of the rock and covered him with his hand as his glory, that the glory of the Lord, passed by, but the Lord did not allow him to see his face. After breaking the tablets of stone, the Lord told Moses to make other tablets of stone and go to the mountain again. Moses went to the mountain with the tablets he had made and was there in the mountain for 40 days and nights without eating anything. The Lord spoke the words of the law, and Moses wrote them down on the tablets of stone. Moses then descended from the mountain and gave the people in commandment all that the Lord spoke with him. Moses put a veil on his face whenever he spoke to the people, because his face shone. It shone with the light. Moses did not cross the Jordan to enter the promised land. It was Joshua, son of Nun, that led Israel into the promised land. Moses went up to the Mount of the top of Mount Pisgah, and the Lord showed him all the land which he promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So the Mount of Pisgah is around here. We have the Mount of Nebo in the land of Moab. So Moses was taken here to the top of the mountain, and he was able to see the promised land, the land of Canaan. Right. At the end of 120 years, Moses died in the land of Moab, and the Lord buried him in the land of Moab against Beth Peor. But no man knows of his sepulcher unto this day. The Bible records in Numbers 12, verse 3, that Moses was very humble, more than any man who was on the face of the earth during his time. Thank you for watching, my dear viewer. I request you to like, to share widely this video, to leave a comment, and to subscribe so that we can support this work of Bible stories to our children and even adults. Thank you so much.